Hi everyone. TQM in education. In this series of episodes, I am trying to explain to all the school correspondents and teachers and principals the relevance of total quality management in educational institution. With my more than 4 decades of experience in TQM implementation in organization, I have seen massive improvement in the satisfaction level of the customers wherever TQM is implemented. So the last 25 years, we have been implementing TQM in organizations. I thought the last 25 years, we have been implementing TQM in education institutions, and we thought we can share our experience on this very important topic, right? In the last episode, I touched upon the relevance of human resources development quality. Ultimately, we should be very clear that we are in a very competitive market. Whether it is an organization or a hospital or an education institution, there are many schools, many colleges, many companies, many products, many service providers, and we have to be the best. And parents will choose such an institution which will contribute to their dream realization. So that is why I am giving these ideas, right? See, we talk about an excellent school. We also talk about below average schools. What makes an excellent school? What makes a below average school? For this, we should understand the end result. See, you have what is called lower order cognition. Cognition is knowledge acquisition. Or you have the higher order cognition. In between, you should know what is the role of the school. See, I teach you something, you remember. Right? This is the rote memory. The child knows how to score marks by just reproducing what is crammed into his brain. The next stage is understanding. Right? So what is read has to be understood. The next stage is application of what is learnt. Then you evaluate the various subjects learnt, the topics learnt. Ultimately, you get into a creative stage. A school which reaches a creative level is excellent school. So ultimately, you need to be very clear that we have to move from lower order cognition to higher order cognition. I hope you have understood what I have said. There is competition. If you want to get more students, more quality students into your institution, you need to move from below average to good and excellent. That is the purpose of the entire discussion we are going to have. Now, see, ultimately, we need to ask a few questions. Every educator should ask questions. Why am I running this school? What is that I want to do? How I want to do it? And who is going to do it? Please understand, why am I running this school? What is that I want to do? How am I going to do what I have to do? And who is going to do that? This clarity should be there. First of all, across the educational institution, this has to be understood. Teachers should understand the school exists not just to cram knowledge, content into the brain of the child. These days, schools talk about mission. What is the mission? What is the vision? In some boards, for example, CBSC, the CBSC has asked every school to come out with a mission statement. For example, as an individual, I have a mission statement. My mission is to make a difference in others' life. So me and my wife, Radha, we want to live to this mission statement. So what is the mission statement? So go discuss with your top management. What is the mission? Right. If that is the mission, what is that I should do in my school? Right. Even if it is simple attendance taking, it is simple teaching them mathematics. How am I going to teach mathematics and who is going to do that? So this is the mission statement. Mission statement is nothing but a public announcement that this is what I want to do. In fact, the moment you answer this question, why I want to do this, many of these questions will be answered. I hope I am making myself very clear. Now, for example, Chinmaya International Vidyalaya, the mission statement reads, to mold children into productive and responsible global citizens with a strong character through holistic education, enriched by the knowledge of Indian culture, a feeling of patriotism, and universal outlook. Now, this is the mission statement. Now, this is the why. If this is why, what is that you want to do? What activities, what initiatives you want to do? What events you want to conduct? How are you going to conduct it? And who is responsible? So, this is one mission statement. You can browse to the internet. There are umpteen number of mission statements are available. For example, Sony, you take organization. At Sony, our mission is to be a company that inspires and fulfills your curiosity. Groundbreaking new excitement and entertainment in ways that only Sony can do. In only ways, only Sony can do. Creating unique new cultures and experience. This is the Sony emblem. Now, if Sony has a mission statement like that, then there are a lot of Sony distributors. In every town, you will have Sony products. Every shop, you'll have more than one product. Each Sony product will reflect that. However, you will not buy a Sony product from any shop. A shop makes a difference. You will not buy the Sony product for any shop. For the same Sony television, 10 different shops will be there. You will not buy it from any of the 10, but you will choose one shop because the experience that you went through is different. Right? So you have a mission statement. You have the product which reflects the quality which the founder wants. And then it is displayed all over. Right? Then there are important questions I thought I should give. Let's say schools are distributors of education. Right? Let's say that there is a consumer product company. The company does not sell across. They have distributors. Hindustan Lever, they have distributors. Britannia, they have distributors. So, education and schooling is the product, like a television. So you have the school A, school B, school C, school D, school E. Same education, wherever you go, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. 10 minus 1 is equal to 9, wherever it is. There are the same alphabet, same geography. Schools do not change the geography, right? But the way it is perceived by the people, that is why even though Sony is the same brand, is identical, but every shop is not making identical sales. Please understand. Right? I hope you have understood education as a product and school is a distributor of a product which is called education. In my time management seminars, I used to link the mission statement into activities. Let's say you have a mission statement. Go and ask your management, they will give you the mission statement of your school, right? So this is my mission statement. Now, let me say my mission is to make a difference in others' life. So then I have various roles. How am I going to live my mission statement? So I have a magazine, right? I am a YouTuber. I am heading a school. I do counseling, right? I write books. I write articles. Now, all these things are my roles. In each role, I have a goal. For each goal, I have a task. And for each task, we have activities. So in the application of TQM, the school's mission statement is deployed. So role, the trustees have a role. They have a goal. They have a task. And they have to do certain activities. Then you have the management members role. They have a goal. They have a task, activities. The trustees have a role. They have a goal. They have a task and activities. Similarly, principals, the head of the department, teachers, office staff, even the person who is collecting cash at the counter, the driver who drives the bus, the conductor who helped the child to get into the bus. Now, everybody should reflect the mission of the school. That means it has to be a homeward. If you do not believe in this, your mission statement is nothing but a paper. Right. So I hope you have understood this. So you have other mission statement of other schools. For example, this says, we foster an enthusiastic, creative community of learners prepared to continue their intellectual, emotional and physical development. This is a mission statement of another school. So I have one interesting mission statement, Delhi Public School. It's a very big statement. In the big statement, the first two are very, very important. It reads, we believe that education is service to society. Our mission is to educate for empowerment and enlightenment. We shall strive to make our school a place where each child's potential is developed to the optimum so that we may reach our goal of excellence in the competitive world. Read this, the second one. We shall strive to make our school a place where each child's potential is developed to the optimum so that we may reach the goal of excellence in the competitive world. Now that means everybody working in this school should reflect this. This is the pulse of the school. I hope you are understanding that. So we should train HR department in the pulse of any organization, because I told you the raw material, the students, they are being processed for a finished product of an educated, wise people, wisdom, right? We are producing engineers, doctors, leaders, right? So this is very, very important, the role of HRE. So training and education is for everybody in the enterprise or in the organization or in the school. It is essential that everybody should be able to make a vast contribution. There's no compromise on that. TQM will be successful only if everybody, including top management and other managers, are thoroughly educated in all aspects of total quality. That's why I said, right from the watchman, the person who handled the telephone call, a grievance is raised by a parent. How do you address the grievance? Do you have a time limit for that? Do you have a format for that? Who attended the grievance? If there is an accident in the school, do you document that? Where the accident took place? How did it take place? Right? What is the procedure? Right? Who should inform whom? What is the telephone number? To whom did you inform? What did you inform? Do you have a system of first aid? If so, what is that first aid? Is the person trained for that? Or a parent raises a grievance. Let's say a teacher has not taught the subject. May be true, may not be true. But do you have a grievance redressal system for that? That's what I'm trying to tell you. For this, these people have to be trained. Right? The first contact and the last contact when the child leaves has to be a delightful experience. Right? Now, that means the human capital is the most valuable asset in any organization or any enterprise. That's why Henry Ford said, take away my plant, take away my money, take away my property, take away everything, but leave my people with you, I will create one more whole organization. Right? Right. So TKM must become a part of company life. We should breathe TKM. Every employee must not only know about TKM, but actually talk quality. Hey, what am I doing? How am I doing? Can I improve? Right? So, the organization must therefore put a well-developed TKM training. Maybe when we work face-to-face, we'll be able to come out with a very clear action plan for implementing TKM. I hope I have made myself clear on the critical role of the HR department and how each and every person should own the responsibility for a total quality. So I go back, what I said, why am I running this institution? If this is the reason, which is the mission statement, what is that I'm going to do? If this is what I have to do, for example, if I have to inform the parent about the accident, how am I going to do that and who is going to do that? I hope you have understood. Please subscribe to the channel if you have not already. Press the bell button so that our updates will come to you. If you have any clarification, if you have any doubts, please post it in the comment box. We'll be very happy to come back to you. All the best. See you in my next episode.
ABS Vidya Mandir, Tiruvallur.
ABS Vidya.